الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My dear respected brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your fast, accept your qiyam, accept your good deeds, and make them sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you all beneficial knowledge and righteous action. To remind you again, in the beginning of the class, that you can text this number, inshallah, in case you have a question, 561-566-6380. And some of the brothers, they were asking if the masjid can provide services in terms of the zakat al-fitr. You must know that the masjid currently is closed, and zakat al-fitr rests upon your shoulder, so you have to figure out, you know, the Muslims in the area that you can give zakat to, zakat al-fitr, and you can give it 2 days before Eid, as long as it is given before Salat al-Eid, because if it is given after Salat al-Eid, it would be considered a sadaqah, it would not be considered as zakat. As for those that ask about the measurement, zakat al-fitr is one sa'a. A sa'a, according to the Permanent Committee of Ifta, is about 3 kilograms. 3 kilograms of rice, or wheat, or barley, or dates, or the like. Inshallah, we're going to continue from where we left off. The Shaykh, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said that zakat has many religious, behavioral, and communal benefits, of which we will mention the following from them. So now, here the Shaykh is going to talk about the intent of the legislator, the wisdom behind the obligation of zakat. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligate upon us to give zakat? So these are the benefits, the wisdom behind it. The first, the Shaykh said, it is abiding by one of the pillars of Islam, upon which rests an individual's prosperity in this world, life, in this worldly life, and the hereafter. There is no doubt. Because Islam is based upon 5 pillars. The testification that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah, and that you establish the salat, and then you give the zakat. So zakat is one of the pillars of Islam. So when you comply with the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by implementing what Allah commanded you to implement, then you gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And your life will be prosperous. And the hereafter will be prosperous as well. So you'll gain in this world and you gain in the hereafter. The Shaykh, he said, number 2, it brings a servant close to his Lord and increases his faith. This is the case with all of the acts of worship. Because when you comply with the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your intent is to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your intent is to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the more good deeds you perform, the closer you get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when someone does not obey Allah disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what's going to happen? Their heart is going to be hard. And they're going to feel distant from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you don't want to be in a situation like that, where you feel alienated. You don't feel that closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You feel emptiness. Your soul is very, there is a spiritual vacuum that needs to be filled. You don't, you know, feel anything. You don't feel the sweetness of Iman. You don't feel the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't feel it. And this is a big problem. This is the punishment of the sins. When someone commits sins, then this person is distanced from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shaykh, he said, number three, what comes as a result of doing it, such a great reward, Allah says, يَمْحَقُ اللَّهُ الرِّبَى وَيُرْبِي الصَّدَقَاتِ. Allah will wipe away the reward of usury, riba, usury, interest, and increase that of a charity, i.e. zakat, Surah Al-Baqarah. So basically, when you give zakat, your wealth will be increased. Allahu Akbar. But when you sell a product, but you charge a person interest, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe away that reward that you gain out of that interest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ رِبَى لِيَرْبُوا فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ فَلَا يَرْبُوا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ وَمَا آتَيْتُمْ مِنْ زَكَاةٍ تُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُضْعِفُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and that which you give as a gift to others in order that it may increase your wealth by expecting something in return from other people's property has no increase with Allah. But that which you give in zakat sincerely for the sake of Allah, those people shall have manifold increase. Allahu Akbar. Look, shall have manifold increase. So rest assured that your wealth is going to be multiplied. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever gives away charity the size of a date which is earned lawfully, that shows you right there that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept only that which is halal, which is halal. And you know the hadith is not hidden from you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned a man who travels extensively. He travels here and there. And this man, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned his condition. He said, disheveled and dust filled, you know, because he's in a state of travel. And when you are in a state of travel, the dua is acceptable. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that the dua of the musafir, the traveler, is acceptable. Likewise, the dua of the fasting person is acceptable, and the dua of the one who has been oppressed is acceptable, and the dua of a just ruler also is acceptable. So, as it is in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, this man, look, his condition, he is in a very humble condition. And this man, he raises his hand, he says, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. He's calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Shaykh Al-Uthaymeen commented on this hadith. He said, look at this man. He is in the most suitable condition for his dua to be acceptable. But yet Allah does not accept the dua of such. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned the reason why. He said, وَطَعَامُهُ مَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامُ مَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامُ وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامُ وَغُدِيَ بِالْحَرَامُ فَأَنَّا يُسْتَجَابُ لِذَاكُ. So he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that his clothing were bought from haram because of his haram earning. The wealth that he earned, he spent on himself, and he bought clothing. So those clothing that he's wearing, they are haram. مَلْبَسُهُ حَرَامُ وَمَطْعَمُهُ حَرَامُ. And his nutrition is haram. وغذي بالحرام, and he's fed الحرام. He said, فأنا يستجاب لذاك. How would Allah accept the dua of such? So the dua of such a person would not be accepted because of الحرام. إن الله طيب لا يقبل إلا طيبا. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that Allah is pure and he does not accept except that which is pure. So we have to strive as much as we can to eat and al-haram, and also to feed our family, to eat al-halal, and to feed ourselves and our family al-halal. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whatever wealth you ما من جسد whatever flesh of the body was fed with al-haram, then the fire is more deserving of that body that was nourished with al-haram. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from that. It's very important. So he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever gives away charity the size of a date which is earned lawfully, since Allah only accepts the good lawful things, that which is halal, Allah will indeed take it with his right hand and cause it to grow for the owner, Allahu Akbar. Just as one of you raises his colt to the point that the charity will become like the size of a mountain, reported by al-Bukhari and Muslim. Look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses al-halal, al-sadaqah that is in halal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts it and blesses it, and it gets increases. Allahu Akbar. Number four, the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala says, Allah wipes away like the minor sins by way of it. Allah wipes away the minor sins by way of it. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, giving charity wipes away sins just as water extinguishes fire. Allahu Akbar. Look at the benefit of giving charity visabilillah. And the word charity, sadaqah, here refers to the zakat, as well as the supurgatory form of charity. From the benefit it has on a person's character are: it causes him to follow the way of the generous individuals possessing kindness. So when you do that, then you are imitating and emulating those who are generous, like of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the like of Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu an, and the companions radwanullahi alayhim. Number two, giving the zakat requires a person to characterize himself with the attribute of mercy and sympathy towards his destitute brothers, and Allah shows mercy to those who have mercy on others. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, irhamu man fil ard yarhamkum man fis sama. Show mercy to those who are upon the earth, then the one who is above the heavens will show mercy to you. As you show mercy to his creation, he will show mercy to you. Number three, what has been witnessed is that giving financial and physical support to Muslims causes the heart to become open and the souls to be pleased. Allahu Akbar. And it causes a person to become loved and respected according to the extent of support he gives to his fellow brothers. And this is very true, because there are some people, subhanallah, they are very distinguished in the community because they are very generous. And then at the time of trial and tribulation, they're always the first one to be there. They're always the first one to give. They're always the first one to aid and support. Allahu Akbar, may Allah make us from them. Number three, what has been witnessed is that giving financial and physical support to Muslims causes the heart to become open, wallahi wallahi, and the soul to be pleased. And it causes a person to become loved and respected according to the extent of support he gives to his fellow brothers. Wallahi wallahi. And there is another benefit I would like to mention. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Sana'i'ul ma'ruf taqi masari' as-su'." He said, "Sana'i'ul ma'ruf taqi masari' as-su'." Meaning that when you do good deeds and you do favors to others and you take care of your brothers and sisters, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repels through them, through those good deeds that you do, calamities, Allahu Akbar. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he saves you from calamities. A calamity was coming your way. And because of those good deeds, those favors, those good deeds that you have done, you know, and you have given your brothers and sisters and you supported them and the like, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save you from calamities by doing those good deeds. Allahu Akbar. The Shaykh, he said, number four, giving zakat cleanses one's character from stinginess and miserliness. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, خُدْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ. Take the charity, zakat, from their wealth in order to purify and cleanse them by way of it. Allahu Akbar. Because zakat cleans you from being stingy. So you show mercy as you sympathize with those who are less fortunate than you. Those could be your own parents, could be your siblings, and could be your relatives, could be someone very close to you, or a friend of yours, or the like. So you show mercy to them. By doing that, Allahu Akbar, you purify your soul from stinginess. The Shaykh, he said, from its communal benefit, the benefit that benefits the society, the Muslim society, is very important. Allahu Akbar. And you don't find this system in any other religion except Islam. You don't find this zakat, charity like this, the way it is organized, and it's taken 2.5% and all this. You don't find it in any other religion except the religion of Islam. The Shaykh said, from its communal benefit is that zakat provides for the needs of the poor, who are the majority of the people in most countries. This is the reality. Because when you look at the majority in any country, you find out that the poor people are the majority. Like, for example, take the country like India. India, majority of the people, they live in slums. And look at these wealthy people. They live in palaces. They have millions. Some of them have billions. And they don't share their wealth with those people who are living in the slums. This is oppression, you know? This is oppression. This is societal oppression. Islam doesn't have that. Islam has justice. The poor, they need to be taken care of. Because if we don't take care of the poor, then we're going to have a problem in the society. We're going to have people going and robbing others. And, you know, looting and doing all kind of things, the evil things. But when we fulfill their need, we fulfill the need of the poor and needy, then they're going to become our brothers and sisters. And they're going to look at us as being very good people. You are really good people and you care about us. But when someone lives in lofty houses and palaces and spends so much money on luxury and other things, some of them, they spend money just going on a cruise. Subhanallah. Thousands of dollars. Bahamas here. Canary Island. Here and there. And there are so many people, they're dying of hunger, subhanAllah. And they're not, they don't care. They don't have a heart, they have a rock in their heart, wal'iyadu billah. They have no mercy for the people. Inshallah, we're going to see if we have any questions. I think we do. We have some questions. Alhamdulillah. So we're going to go ahead and answer these questions. Bi-idhnillah. One question from Brother Ibrahim. May Allah grant him tawfiq. The brother, he said, who do we give the zakat if we can't attend the masjid? Right now, as you know, barakallahu feek, the masjid is closed. The masjid is closed. So probably what you can do, you can get in contact with Brother Sharif, because Brother Sharif knows some families in the area, some poor families in the area. Maybe you can have the zakat delivered to their home. This will be the best thing because of social distancing and the like. So the best thing to do, to get their number and call them and introduce yourself. You tell them that I am from, North Palm Beach Islamic Center community, Islamic Center. And I would like to give some zakat. And I heard that you are needing of it. And alhamdulillah, you can arrange with them. And the rest of the, whoever wants to do that, it would be a good idea. If you wanna drive up there, wear a mask, wear your gloves and everything, take the precautionary measures and go up there. It is even better if you can do it yourself. Go and deliver the zakat to them. Yeah. Because the masjid, as you know, it is closed right now. There is nobody there. There is nobody at the masjid. So the masjid is not doing that at the moment. But inshallah, I will speak to Brother Sharif, inshallah ta'ala, to provide the numbers of those families who are needy in the area in Palm Beach County. They're not very far. They're not very far from here. So inshallah, we will arrange for that, so that everyone, inshallah ta'ala, will be able to give the zakat to those families, either to drive up there and give it to them, or to have it delivered to their homes. Na'am, barakallahu feekum. And just to remind you, because some people ask about the weight, it's one sa'. One sa' is about 3 kilograms, approximately. 3 kilograms of rice. So if you have two people in a household, so 6 kilograms. So each one gives 3 kilograms of rice. Barakallahu feekum. Another question from Brother Abdul Rahim. Barakallahu feek, Brother Abdul Rahim. I have a question about credit card used without collecting interest. For instance, if you spend on the card and you pay the full $100 before receiving any statement, is this permissible? Plus they give cash back bonus, is this permissible? Barakallahu feek, what I know, that the credit card, they are not permissible, barakallahu feek. They are not permissible. This is what I know from the scholars. Because credit card, usually, if you are late, they will charge you interest. This is what I know. Correct me if I'm wrong. I don't know any other way, wallahu alam, that using a credit card, it would lead to interest eventually. It would lead to interest eventually. Barakallahu feek. And they give cash back bonus. I don't know about that. I wouldn't be able to say if it is halal or haram. Allahu alam. Nah. Okay, inshallah, we're going to continue from where we left off, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. The Sheikh, rahimahullahu ta'ala, he said, First of all, zakat provides for the needs of the poor, who are the majority of the people in most countries. Number two, zakat strengthens the Muslims and raises their status. This is why one of the areas zakat can be given is jihad in the cause of Allah, as we will mention later, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, it removes the grudges and all feelings found in the hearts of the poor and destitute. This is since when the poor see the money the wealthy have and they're not benefiting them with it, by giving them neither a little nor a lot, then it is likely that they will hold hatred and rancor for the wealthy, as they did not enforce their rights or provide for their needs. But when the wealthy do give some of their money to them at the beginning of every year, i.e. after holding the wealth for a year's time, these things subhanallah, look at this, will terminate and there comes about love and harmony. Look, subhanallah. Number four, giving zakat boosts one's health, one's wealth, and increases its blessedness, as it is stated in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in which he said, charity does not detract from one's wealth. Allahu Akbar. This means that even through charity, zakat takes away from one's wealth numerically, right? It indeed never takes away from its blessedness or its increasing in the future. Rather, Allah will replace what He gave away and bless His wealth. Allahu Akbar. Number five, zakat is a means for spreading and distributing wealth throughout the community. This is since if some wealth is given out, its range is broadened and many people benefit from it. Contrary to when the wealth is just preserved among the rich, since the poor will not gain any part of it. Allahu Akbar. All of these benefits that come from giving zakat show clearly that zakat is something necessary and required in order to rectify the individual and the society. How perfect is Allah, the all-knowing, the most wise. I believe we have a question from Brother Haydar, inshallah, regarding if someone has acid reflux during fasting, do they have to spit it out? If they have acid reflux, they can spit it out. Yes, absolutely. They can spit. Now, they can. Barakallah feek. They can spit it out. No problem. Naam. And up to here, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficial knowledge and righteous action. Walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wait. I also know you mentioned about having to spit out mucus. What about the one who has post-nasal drip, where it is constant dripping of the mucus? If it is something that a person cannot control, there is no blame upon that person, barakallahu fi. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Allah will not hold some soul accountable for something beyond its scope, like acid reflux or mucus or something like excessive that you cannot control, there is no blame upon you. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficent knowledge and righteous action. Walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.